The Suns are looking to defeat their Western Conference rival going into this game. And here it comes, the NBA on 2K Sports. For myself, Kevin Harlan, and my broadcast partners, Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. Welcome, everyone. You look at Minnesota. They feel like they're a better team than their record shows. And Timberwolves trail by 5. On Phoenix, looking who they've got on the floor. We've got Green. Miles Plumlee out there with Anthony Tolliver. Then it's Thomas. And it's Dragic in at the 2. Martin kicks to Young. Shot clock at 6. From 11 feet away, and he's able to get it back. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Young's got 7. And G's subbed in for this.
He'll be signed to this team for the rest of the season. What a weight off his shoulders to hear that.
You know, it really is. As much as he had been focused on the game, he always had that what-if feeling in the back of his head. And now he can put that to rest knowing he'll be on the roster. That's a good feeling. They've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball into the paint.
Yeah, they've been the aggressors, Clark. And getting the ball inside into that lane area has been huge for them.
Well, there's got to be something about Washington producing these 5'9 guards. I mean, whether you're talking Nate Robinson or Isaiah Thomas, they both can fill it up in a hurry. And, you know, they both play the game with the confidence and swagger of a power forward.
Great D that time from G.
You know, typically, guys, he has the body control to finish when he's in that tight. I'm not sure what happened there. That is a quick bucket. Pretty good in transition.
That's right. That's exactly right. He loves when he gets the chance to get out and run. That's when he's at his best.
Brewer is checked in for Kevin Martin. And the Suns here with a different look. Morris is checked in for Plumlee. Morris comes in for Anthony Tolliver. P.J. Tucker, he's checked in for Green. And it's Eric Bledsoe in for Isaiah Thomas. They set the pick. Bledsoe dishes to Tucker. He kicks to Morris. Puts it up from 15. That's good.
Assist goes to P.J. Tucker.
Minnesota comes into this one following a loss to Golden State.
I think their attitude going into that game was all wrong. And I think they believed what was being said about them, that it was a game they couldn't win, and they just didn't have any confidence.
I'm not going to go with you on that one, Steve. I don't agree with that. I think they believed in themselves. I just think the talent difference between the teams was far too much for them to overcome.
And it seems like nothing is falling for him this quarter. He's really out of his rhythm.
And he gets the bucket. 9 points for Goran Dragic.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
And that one's good.
Now, there's something for the top 10 highlight reel right there. A layup can be just as sweet and as pretty as a dunk sometimes.
We've got 108 left in the first quarter. Feeds it to Tucker. Back to Dragic. Down low. Here's Morris. That's in, coming off an assist from Dragic. Morris has got his second bucket tonight.
Boy, I really love the way Dragic spreads that ball around.
Here's G. His last outing, 16 points for him. He feeds it to Young. The fader misses off the left iron.
Well, he hasn't had much success shooting the ball, but it's not too late for him to get it turned around and start contributing.
Outside Dragic. Some nice ball movement here by the Suns. And that one's good.
Marcus.
Now it's a 5-point Phoenix lead.
Great teamwork out there, really helping each other out.
Their plan is one. I mean, they're like a symphony. Everybody in harmony and in beat and in rhythm. 5 straight baskets now have resulted because of assist.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. And a wide open look here for Wiggins. And it's off from 3-point range. Here's Bledsoe. And he banks in the layup. Bledsoe's got his first points of the night.
Boy, I'll bet his teammates love playing with him. He's distributing the ball perfectly.
Well, he keeps everybody happy, and you know what? The assist numbers don't lie.
A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through one. Suns lead by 7. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And taking a look at the Suns' performance here, Clark and Steve, what have they been doing or not doing?
They set the tone there defensively with their shot blocking. So they've been really intimidating down in the paint area.
You know, in the rest of the game, Steve, shooters will be looking around for the shot blockers because of what's happened in this quarter.
And Phoenix, look at who they've got on the floor. Isaiah Thomas out there at Bledsoe. Then there's Markieff Morris. Then there's Warren. And it's Tucker in at the three spot.
Phoenix Suns franchise with the fourth best winning percentage in NBA history. Maybe we shouldn't have been surprised with their resurgent play last season. This is a franchise that throughout its history has found ways to win.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Now let's send it to Doris from the sideline.
Well, gentlemen, Gerald Green was the 18th pick back in 2005. But remember, he fell out of the league for a while, saying, quote, "I took things for granted. I didn't know how to be a pro, but I learned from my mistakes. I understand now this is not a hobby. This is a job. Now I'm a better professional, a much better player, and I'm all about winning." Kevin?
Nice comeback story, Doris. Nice story. Thank you. Well, when you look at the Suns two seasons ago, their worst winning percentage since the team's inaugural season, Clark, back in 1968.
And at that time, their third straight season missing the playoffs. That hadn't happened since the 80s, but boy, did they bounce back in a big way.
They were tough last year, you're right. Suns leading by 7. Finish off the break. Tucker's got his first bucket in this one.
What a crisp pass to find his open teammate.
Minnesota's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. G passes to Pekovic. Williams kicks to Brook. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Tell you what, Kevin, they'd love to see him get a lot more of those opportunities.
Clark, that deficit will go away quickly if he dives.
Man, I like the way he capped that drive off, guys, with the one-hand punch.
Minnesota making a switch. Martin's checked in. Also making some changes. Miles Plumlee's checked in for Markieff Morris. Tolliver comes in for P.J. Tucker, and it's Green in for Eric Bledsoe. Passes it to Warren. On the wing, Green. Tries it again. The shot's good from Plumlee. Plumlee's got the lead up to 9 now for the Suns.
Just seems like they're finding an open lane to the hoop every time down. It's 5 buckets in a row for them in the paint.
Yeah, on the flip side, Steve, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Hi, Kevin. Flip Saunders was just going over the plan with his team. He'd like them to concentrate on their transition game to keep the tempo fast and put pressure on the defense in the open court. He was also adamant that they can take advantage of this defense with the use of solid ball screens and the pick and roll game. Maybe making those early adjustments will give them time to judge their effectiveness by halftime. We'll soon find out, Kevin.
All right, Doris, here's G. Green with the block. Now, here's Warren. He picked up 12 points in their last win against Houston. And the basket by Thomas. Let's look at the energy stats, how the hustle game has been going for the Suns.
What great hustle defensively through 2 quarters of play, contesting everything, starting to rack up those block shots, guys.
Something else they've done right so far from the get-go tonight is run. I mean, so much of their offense has come off the fast break.
Young, a screen on Green. G kicks to Young. It's deflected. Thomas against Williams. Double team on Thomas. He dishes it to Tolliver. On the wing, Green. Off target from outside. Timberwolves trail by 11.
Thaddeus Young is a left-hander out of Georgia Tech. Only played 1 year in college and has really rounded into a nice pro. He's a very unique player. He's a face-up, slashing power forward with a lightning-quick first step. And he's really hard to keep in front.
Thomas dishes to Green. back to Thomas. Terrific assist, a nice finish, solid play all around.
They have repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid dividends.
Yeah, it sure has, Clark. I mean, with as many points as they've gotten in the paint, they really haven't had to do much on the perimeter.
And Thaddeus Young able to outquick most of his opponents, especially Steve in transition.
Yeah, nice spin move getting to the rim and a creative finisher in close. He's got the hook, the scoop, the floater. This guy's dangerous in a lot of different ways.
So for Phoenix, their last game, a win against Houston.
Yeah, it didn't seem to be much of a challenge for them in that game. It seemed like they scored at will. Not much defense that they were facing.
Yep, they had the defense on its heels early the entire game, and actually nearly the entire game, and no matter what unit was out there, looked like a mismatch to me.
Double team on Thomas. The pass to Plumlee. Some nice ball movement here by the Suns. Thomas with the ball, and it's Martin picking him up. Just three to shoot. And the shot by Warren, no good.
And you know why he was open there. They didn't commit too much defense to him, and you can see why. He has trouble making that shot.
Here's G, guarded by Green. Here's Pekovic, lays it up and banks it in. And now just a 5-point Suns lead.
You know, I think anytime the shot comes from that range, the offense has done its job and done it well.
Thomas against Williams, and the wide open shot from Warren, and the Suns miss again.
Okay, no excuses there. Got a really good look at the basket after being freed up by the pick.
We say it all the time. The execution was excellent. The result not as good, but good ball movement anyway.
G passes to Bekovic. Out of bounds. Phoenix takes possession.
Well, that's
dialed in from long range. I like it.
In for Nikola. So we've reached the end of the first half of play. Phoenix ahead, up 11. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, obviously a lot of ground for you guys to make up in that second half. Do you expect Coach to shake things up to try to jumpstart you here in the third?
I wouldn't be surprised if he did. We came out late to ag that first half, straight up. Right now, any change to wake us up would be welcome. But we know we can play a lot better than that.
Hang tough, young man. Kevin, this league is not easy on the young ones.
Thank you so much, Doris. Great interview as always. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back for the second half of basketball shortly.
All right, everyone's eyes up here. If we're going to send these fans home happy, we've got to go over some things.
I like the way we're valuing the basketball. Keeping those turnovers down has really helped us throughout the first two quarters.
But we've shot the ball well, I'll give us that. And it's because we've had great shot selection. We've made really good choices with the ball.
For the third quarter, we have got to utilize our pick and roll, and in a big way. We can make up some ground quickly if we do, and it will help us establish a rhythm.
We don't have any excuses for putting ourselves in this hole. All we can do is give everything we got to dig ourselves out of it.
Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the third and fourth quarters. You have to like what we're seeing from Goran Dragic.
And all of a sudden tonight, he's become their big assist man. I mean, his passing was the key to their offense in that first half. Not something you always see. And that's
not... Let's go. You're up.
My time.
Here's Rubio. Rubio and Martin manning the backcourt. Wiggins is out there with Young. And it's Bekovic in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. So that's the Timberwolves five. Martin kicks to Wiggins. Rubio outside. Six on the shot clock. Martin from outside. And the shot is good.
He's got a nice stroke from long range. And, you know, he's not likely to pass up those opportunities when he gets them.
G's checked in for Minnesota. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Yes, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Jeff Hornacek as he addressed his team. He told the players, let's put our foot on them and keep them down. We've got them exactly where we want them. I want to see you guys slow the pace, use the clock, and stay away from any silly fouls.
Huge play on the offensive glass to come away with the second chance points. Tell you what, he's getting more and more physical as this game wears on.
And Plumlee kicks to Thomas. There's the bucket. Good. Thomas got 4 points in the quarter.
You know, they've been able to depend on his offense all game long, guys. He's drained a lot of shots out here.
And between now and the horn, Steve, the ball should be in his hands as much as possible if they want to continue to build this lead.
Here's G. Martin kicks to G. The Timberwolves need to get a shot off here. Martin. That doesn't go either for Martin.
Great defense there. You really have to challenge him at that range.
And Thomas, here we go. Wasted no time on that shot, but it's off the mark. Timberwolves trail by 5. The dish to Martin. To the middle. Here's G. Martin with a screen on Dragic. To the wing right side. Wiggins dishes to Young. Offline with his 3. Phoenix leading by 5. The drive by Green. Right side Dragic. Back to Green. Pass to Plumlee. Plumlee's got 12 points here in the second half. Minnesota's gone 2-of-5 on 3-point shots since the end of the third quarter. Here's G. Pekovic with a screen on Thomas.
Been a good night so far for Pekovic, 11 rebounds, and he's done his job at the charity stripe. He's gotten 4 of his points from there.
Man, that's a good place to get them. You know, they don't come easier than that, but you've got to get yourself there first.
He's done a much better job of getting to the line here, aggressively taking it inside and not shying away from contact. I thought he was settling a bit in the first.
Now, you can't say enough about his composure in big moments. He's as cool as they come, guys.
1:52 left in the fourth quarter. G passes to Pekovic. Here's G. He's guarded by Thomas. Kemba goes in, and the Suns' lead is cut to just 3 points on the basket from G. Phoenix has gone ice cold from three-point land, 0-4 since the start of the final quarter. Thomas kicks to Green. Against Dragic. Dishes it to Plumlee. And that's good. And it's Dragic with the assist. Plumlee's got 20 points.
Boy, he's been locked in. Anytime he's gotten an even halfway decent look, he's knocked it down.
And I think they'd be staring at a big deficit if they hadn't gotten the lights out shooting he's given.
Martin with a screen on Thomas. Outside, Martin. 6 to shoot. Pass to Pekovic. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Pekovic has got 10 points now just in this quarter.
So far, going for more of an inside game here in the second half. I like that. A little smash mouth basketball, taking it inside.
Dragic kicks to Green. Back to Dragic. Here's Plumlee. The shot misses. And Minnesota now the other way. G dishes to Pekovic to tie it up. Young's shot is off.
He slipped into quite a funk here, Clark.
I think that's a good word to describe it. I mean, the basket is looking awfully small to him at the moment.
Out of bounds, Minnesota takes possession. Eric Bledsoe has checked in for Phoenix. 3 seconds separate the shot clock and game. In the corner, it's Wiggins. kicks to G. Right wing. From downtown, buries the triple. A tremendous three to tie it up.
Huge points. That's beyond huge, Steve. I mean, they needed that bucket. Desperate.
Rogic kicks to Plumlee.
Count it!
Well, I tell you what, he's having one of those days where if he takes it, he makes it.
Minnesota with the ball. Here's G. The feed now to Bekovic. Ooh, offline. So it's the Suns taking the W in a close one. Clark, it was anybody's game right to the very end.
Yeah, it was. The coach is happy with the outcome. This team kept their emotions in check and got it done.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Guys, I'm here with Goran Dragic. And what's been the key to your success tonight and in general for the team of late?
In the last two games, everybody is playing for each other. You know, we're sharing the ball. We are active in defense and we run. I think so. Last two games, that was the key. Everybody was involved. Everybody was shooting the ball well, and here's the result.
Sharing is contagious. Goran, thanks for your time. Guys, back to you.
All right, Doris, thanks.
Yo, so what's up? It's not every day that you in the hood.
Just wanted to drop a little knowledge your way. We're in an exclusive club. Lots of people think the NBA life is easy, but I know different. There are ups and downs, pressures people got no clue about. Wanted to make sure you're doing okay.
Oh, yeah, man, I'm good.
All right, because if I've learned anything, it's about, man, going out there, hooping, enjoying what you want to do in life, and making sure you're ready each and every game.
I was in town with another one of my clients, Dante Exum, and had to see if the rumors were true. Guess they are. New digs. Look who's moving up in this world. I'm sure you already know Dante, the biggest player to come out of Australia since ever. He can run the point, move over to the two guard, whatever anybody needs. He's about to take the league by storm.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
And this is the man I was telling you about, Dante. Destined to be the biggest undrafted success in the history of the league. Ballin', making money, going places.
Maybe, but he's gonna have to go through me to get there.
Ha! Boy, you acting like that's a challenge.
Take it however you want. You see what I mean on the court.
Fellas, let's keep it cordial. We're all in the same money-making family here.
Another one of them flip mode joints. Bust the vibes, y'all. Word mother, y'all. Check it out, y'all. Just sing to the left, sing to the right. Make you feel good, make you feel alright. One time, feel good, yeah, y'all. Bust the vibes in the place, y'all. Nigga, you feel real good, y'all. Flip mode, the squad in the place, y'all.